Hello and welcome to my Farsi class. Today I am going to continue teaching you how to write letters in Farsi and how to pronounce each letter. Okay, today we are going to learn four letters which, interestingly enough, would be written almost the same way. As you can see, I'm drawing almost the same shape. And the only difference between these four letters would be the number and the place of dots that you will see. Alright, the first one has one dot in the belly, second one three dots in the belly, third one no dot, and the fourth one dot above. Okay, now I'm also going to write for you the small version or the joint version of these letters. For now, just look at them. Don't worry about how each of these letters sounds. In fact, we're just practicing how to write them at this stage. Okay, as you can see, the big letter has the belly and the small letter doesn't have that belly. But the number and the place of dots would be fixed. Okay, the first letter here that you see sounds like J. The second one like CH in English, which is CH. The third one HE. And the fourth one CHE, which in fact doesn't exist in English. So sometimes you will see it transcribed with X. Okay, now we are going to focus on every single one of these letters so that you can understand how to write and how to pronounce each of these letters perfectly. Okay, so look how my hand is moving. One stroke above, one stroke below. That is the head of the letter, and one belly under the line. So basically, one up, one down, and one big belly. Okay, one stroke, two stroke, three strokes. Okay, so you see that it's not really difficult. Make sure that you're not removing your finger from the paper, because you want to continue writing the letter in one stroke, basically. Okay, so this is the first one, which is the letter Jim. In Farsi, it's called Jim. It has one dot in the belly, as you can see. This is the one that is the equivalent of the letter J in English. For now, please focus on where the dot is. So one dot in the belly. And this is the small form, the small version, without the belly. Still, we have the sound J, but the letter doesn't have the belly anymore. So this is the equivalent of J, and the sound is J. Now, one way to remember it is because the small letter J in English has one dot on top of it. So this letter in Farsi has one dot too, but this time in the belly or under it. That's the way to remember. Now, I'm going to show you how this letter would be used in an actual word. Look at this word. We have the sound J at the beginning and the sound T at the end, as you remember from the previous video. So this is the word jet. Jim and T. Jet. In Farsi, of course, we do not write the short vowels, but that's another lesson. For now, just focus on the first letter in this word. As you can see, this is the letter Jim. The sound is J, as you can see in the word jet, which actually means jet, like a jet airplane. So, very easy. J has one dot and Jim also has one dot. Now we're going to go to the next one. You have to just be very careful with the number and the place of dots when you work with these letters in Farsi. Okay, the next one that I'm going to show you is simply just this shape that you saw at the beginning. This time, there is no dot. Yay, nothing to remember. So, the letter which has no dot and is written like this is the equivalent of H in English. So, the sound is he, right? Now you can look that in a word. This is how it looks like. The first letter in this word is he. It's the Arabic word hob, which also can be used in Farsi sometimes, in poetry maybe, in old school Farsi. It means love, but we don't really use it in contemporary Farsi in that sense. Either case, the first letter is he, the sound like H in English, and it's read as hob. So, this one was not difficult either. We are going to go to the third one now. Okay, so the third one, again the same shape. And this time we have three dots in the belly. The small letter version also has three dots under. So remember, so far we had Jim with one dot in the belly, then we had He with no dot, and now we have Che, the equivalent of CH, the sound Che, with three dots in the belly. Okay. So, as you can see, this letter is a little bit more sophisticated, has three dots. The same way that the English sound che is produced by putting two letters next to one another, ch. So remember, the one, the sound that contains two letters, is a little bit more sophisticated in Farsi because it has three dots. So in this word, for example, we have chap, which means left side. And again, the first letter, as you can see, is che. I hope you remember all the other letters from the previous video. I'm just trying to review everything for you. Okay. Now we get to the last one. The last one is the one that in fact doesn't exist in English. However, we have it in Farsi and in some other languages, such as Hebrew, for example. This sound exists. And you have to learn how to pronounce it. So this time we have one dot above the letter. It's very important to remember that now the dot is above the letter. If you remember, this sound was che, which sometimes is written as kh or x in English. So che is produced as a glottal sound. It's as if you want to try to produce a sound from the bottom of your throat. Che. So for example, here we have the word chob. The first letter is che, chob. And chob in Farsi means well, or fine, something like that. Okay. Now, let's do a quick review. We have this letter, Jim, the sound was J, like the J in English. Then we had He, like H in English, He, the sound. Then we have the letter Che, with three dots, CH in English. And we have He, which doesn't exist in English. Jim, He, Che, He. Remember, Jim as J, He as H, Che as CH, and He as KH, or X. Okay. Not difficult to write, maybe a little bit tricky to remember the number and the place of dots, but you can get it with a little bit of practice. Remember how it is written. Three motions, one stroke. Jim has one dot inside the belly, He has no dot, Che has three dots inside the belly, and He has one dot above. Very good. Take a moment to look. Not that bad. Okay. I hope it has not been very challenging. I don't think it is. It just needs a little bit of practice, basically, for you to remember everything. Either case, I'm very happy that you had a chance to watch the video. And thank you, merci, a as we say in Farsi, borrowed from French. And I will say until the next video, Khoda hafiz. Now, remember, we just learned two letters here. Kh in Khoda and He in hafiz. How cool is that? Now you could recognize two of these letters in this word. Okay, bye.